Welcome back to the continued adventures of Hill Orc Fighter Giac of Ilsiuw. Today's itinerary is to clear Shoals 4. And at least breach Spire 4. Normally one might want to delay the invaults of Spider and, well, of the Lariable branches and proceed to Elf before doing them. But in this case, I want to have Ellie for the invaults, and I'm willing to spend all of the Ellie piety doing these invaults, because I intend to switch to Bio for Elf. So that's the plan. The stair looks good. I don't want to blink off this stair, so I think reflection is the better choice. The turtle has wandered off. That's unusual. Okay. A wind drake. You love her. Is a good counter. Not sure what else I can do, except... Oh, that was good. Airstrike. Venom is good here because it can pull range at will, and then I can't touch it. Like so. I guess one sometimes makes a splashing noise when entering the water, similar to opening a door. Doesn't have anything to do with flying, because I was not flying just then. So, what I do not want is to have the band in this vault charge out and interdict my line of retreat. So the door must be somewhere on this side. So I'm going to come at it from this stair instead of continuing to explore. Could trigger an alarm trap at any time. So I need to mind my line of retreat. So there's a door. Curious what else is around here. Time to take a peek, I suppose. Contestant number one. And two. I don't need blink, so I can bring up reflection. Looks like his returning weapon returns even if it hits him. Too bad. I guess I'll keep the reflection on as I descend. Best way to handle the javelinier is just to use physical damage, I think. Or I could flame him to try to claim the javelins of returning before he mulches them. He'll do that. taken care of. It's a good haul. You could have kept up that attack for a long time. Looks like it might be just the siren. Which is great. Manticore. I think I can attract him just by swapping to reflection. Yep. And an impaler. So I'll take the sea snake up. I'll leave reflection on to the manticore. May as well just go back up. Try that again. I have good AC, but poison will counter that. The trident of protection might be better than the falchion of protection. pole arms is trained higher than long blades. Plus 4 accuracy versus plus 1. Well, I think the falchion is still better. That's a good follower weapon anyway. I think I could yell. Nothing. Here's the Windrake. Probably the reason that the Windrake was so conveniently available to pull was that I yelled and brought him to the edge of his vault. Super Turtle. Moving fast. If he bites too hard, I may have to blink away. It's got crazy AC. If I had confusion needles or something, it might be good. Well, this rapier is just wrecking. Refresh the poison. Okay, maybe try to finish with the Morningstar. Now with this much AC, I should just stick with the lightning. Alright, well it's almost dead, I think Morningstar. Whoa, there's that bite. Yeah. That might be it for the vault. Good. Excellent. Hulk has plus 1 fire and plus 0 conjurations, so it's nice to have. Although there's very little need for damage, extra damage with Bio. So, well, anyway, that's one vault cleared, which means now it's safe to challenge the vault to the west without getting ambushed. or tomahawks. I guess I can engage. Maybe I'll use some reflection as well. Well, I don't want to spring the vault here, so I'll work my way back around. Here we go. Slow turtle. Fan of gales would be nice. Probably nicer than my one digging, which is more of a strategic resource. Dream sheep. Oop, I've lost my flight. Okay, I think I'll take reflection here to deal with Polyphemus. Take the Merfolk Cup. I should probably figure out which of my weapons is most effective versus Merfolk. Find that out now, but I should register my guess first. Maces is a strong contender, so is the Elect Rapier. And the Piercing Rapier. I really don't know, I think this one's close. Nine point two, 8.6. Eight point five. Yeah, it's close because I was correct. It is really close. So, I guess for reliability, the +6 rapier is the best choice for finishing Merfolk. Which is what I've been doing, so I was correct. So that's the benefit of using FSIM. Eventually you develop an intuition that's reliable. I actually impressed myself there. Okay. Reflection or region is the question. I think I'm going to have Regen up, because if I take Polyphemus up, I may need to blink away. He hits too hard. slept. Okay. And I can swing this axe. I think I'll do that. Just to make sure I get a even pull of about half the pack. Oh, this is just a standard Cyclops, it's not Polyphemus. So the Polyphemus wannabe. One of the unnamed Cyclops herders. Impaler. Tried in a freezing, still is not interesting. Demon tried in a freezing is nice. I should have protection from cold. Yep, just a bit late on that. Okay, well, he's got a lot of HP left, so maybe the rapier will carry this along. I could switch stairs, but I don't trust this stair. It's a bit too hectic. I would need to clear this vault from this stair first, which actually is arguably safer than challenging this vault, which is also close to that vault. Looks like this is the edge, so that would be pretty safe. Since I'm hurt anyway. It's a good time to switch stairs. Could have raged on the impaler instead of chunks. Unlikely to be an opening on this edge. It would seem, judging by the pattern so far. Whoa. That was a big screw-up. I was thinking that it would be on the west wall, but obviously that doesn't make sense. So now I'm barbed, and yeah, I could steam it up. That would be a good move. I've got regen, so I can hold this choke point for a bit. If I hadn't been commentating about walls and so forth, then I wouldn't have screwed up the execution of. I don't want to flame the turtle because I won't miss. I want to generate a lot of steam in here. So I'll do this instead, I think. This will be better, it'll be closer to the nymph. More spikes. Not what I wanted to happen. I could polymorph that manticore, although it is risky. I could enslave something. The nymph is going to water teleport, which would be annoying. What I should do is just step to the side, and that would have saved me barbs as well. The flame was the wrong play there. Oh well. So I'll take the barbs and prepare to hold this choke point. Okay, the water nymph is... she can do a lot of damage, so I need to nuke her down quickly. The barbs are gone, so I can blink, but... well, I don't think she's fast in water, so... I can just... oh, not flying. I can just walk away here. Yep. Lost the stair. But I got some time to regen just then. Cool. I always just assumed that water nymphs were fast, but it makes sense that since they can do so much irresistible damage, walking away from them is possible. Question is, what to enchant? The rapier of electrocution is a very good weapon. The war axe is working okay, I feel. But if I'm going to have trouble, it's going to be from getting surrounded or what? Blowgun is working well enough in Spider. I like the rapier a lot. So I think I'll enchant that. Okay. Well, I can continue sweeping to the south. This might be a corner, which would be good. Okay, good. Yeah, the blowgun is working well enough already. Doesn't need another buff. It's not like I have a bunch of specialized needles, such as confusion, that I want to pump up. Didn't really need to step forward, I could have lured the turtle more. The avatar is dangerous when there's deep water around, which there is not right here, so it's a good place to challenge her. But the stairs are even better. Assuming I don't get mesmerized, that is. So really, stairs are not that great. Drowned souls are able to make their way over. I'm very distant, off screen, and now mesmerized. Great. Well, I can break line of fire, I think. No. No, I can't. I mean, line of sight. If there were enough tiles in between, I could bring up steam to break line of sight, but that won't work. So I have to think about what I want to do. I don't think she can sustain her mesmerize if she's silenced. It's an interesting thing to find out, so it's worth doing file of floods just to find that out. Or I could polymorph her. Her MR is great though, so go with the file of floods. Boom. If nothing else, it should kill her quickly. Okay, I'm adjacent. I think I want the rapier. Looks like the drowned souls are getting replaced by other drowned souls before they reach me, so that's great. And then these are just standard merfolk. Not really a problem. But the... I don't know if the watermelt elemental is ever engulfed. But it wouldn't make sense for engulfed to silence merfolk anyway, would it? Since they can breathe underwater. Anyway, it didn't work that time, is all I can conclude. A satyr. He is wrecking my water elementals. He has ear and sleep. Better engage him with MR up. Longbow velocity is a good follower weapon. What could that scroll be? Requirement, silence, or torment? What would I acquire? A weapon would be good. I'd likely get a better axe. Armor is doing well already. Jewelry is doing pretty well. I think a weapon. Crystal mace. No identifier. Well, seems safe to read this blind. Requirement it is. I could take gold, but there will always be more gold, so I'll take a weapon. A steaming hunting sling. Interesting. We'll have to wait for an identify scroll though. Slings can't be distortion. Might still have star contam or star drain, I suppose. Can they? It's an artifact. Could be fragile as well. Can delay gratification. There's no rush. Enchant weapon. I can buff the blowgun again. Be super effective in Spider. Or Spider 4. Or I could go with the Morning Star so that I have a way of fighting Emperor Scorpions. I think the Rapier is a better answer to Emperor Scorpions, though. Let me do that again. It's kind of an in-game weapon, Rapier of Elec. Aquamancer with a Lek. Shouted with no answering shouts. I want to try to reflect and protection from cold. Just steamed himself. Herself. Easy enough. I like how isolated this vault is. And I like the teleport trap. Merfolk Impaler. I'm trying to do nothing. So that was all airstrike. Yeah. Oh, it's gonna fly. Whoops. So this is annoying. But I can stay in this nook and do some lesser healing. Up there. Okay, I didn't expect that he would blow away his ally. Probably could have done that better by yelling smaller pull out of the vault. But the nice thing about Ellie is this situation has always been completely under control because chance of pacification is 87%. Time to recuperate a bit. Should be fine to go into troll with her armor. The training Aquamancer is not a problem. I already have RN plus. 2 pips. So, just bring up the reflection. It blinked. There it is. Reflection. I don't want to be teleported by getting knocked back, so move over a bit. Safe enough to cut through the middle now, since I've cleared it on 3 sides at least. Minimal patrols remain. I can just charge this siren. Put on reflection. And again. Missed the addition of the impaler. File of Floods is back. That's a simulacrum cracking. Yep. Interesting. I bet the best way to fight it is... Yeah, I can only slip one tentacle through that. Gap. The stair's a bit hot. Oops, forgot to equip the resist cold. Some pretty good damage. Some lacrim's done. That's a siren, it's time to go. Patrolling impaler. Enough. I don't always spot monsters when they arrive due to the heavy redshift in my screen. That's alright. It's alright in this branch anyway. Try to yell the nymph over. There she is. Thank you. Aquamancer. I reflected the primal wave if I didn't know that was possible. Surprising. Whoops. Forgot about my training again. Okay, so still at 17. Hasn't changed the secondary target yet. 8. Nothing much has changed. Up to them in anticipation, I can probably level that. Drake, my favorite, totally not annoying monster. Ilsiuw. Call Tide. If I try to attack her with water elementals, she can abjure. Sounds like an attrition fight. She does have some armor. One in three chance to pacify, or to one in four. Too much EV. We could try netting her. Nets won't mulch if one misses, I believe. So, that's an interesting option. Wait till she's adjacent, net her, she might blink out of it. Not a hex here, so. I think I should take her up first, and then I can blink around with impunity. like she's not going to close. Unsurprising. The Impaler will. Called the time. We could enslave. I don't think that would end well. I'll just aim to pick off an impaler. There's a siren. Need MR. Crap. Okay. And I'm engulfed, of course. I'd have to get lucky to break a line of fire. Fog might do it. Then again, it probably would not. Maybe this is a good time to blink. I'm engulfed. So, at least that will be improved. Pick up blink. Cool. Invoke flight. Netted. Time to blink again. Not the blink I wanted. Sirens on screen. We could teleport out of this mess, but I'm still got plenty of HP. Full HP, in fact. Don't want to get sirened again. But if I do, I might just teleport. Yeah. Let's go for the protection from magic. There's the first hit. And now I'm on land. Should be all good. Got me again, even though I had maxed out my MR. It's a 5% chance. Well, blinking seems to break it pretty well, so I could just try that. Although they're not really close enough to justify blinking yet. I can bring out my own water elementals, but they'll get abjured. I could do an ice blast. Pretty clumped together. Seems that Ilsiuw has RC plus aerobo resistance. They're hitting me with trident, so they're not going to close. I could rage, but that's not smart. She'll look away. On the other hand, maybe it is smart. Because then I can purify it off, and purify off the slow, and go upstairs, presumably. Engulfed. I could step and enrage. Why can't I? I can't enrage while mesmerized. Interesting. Okay, well. The siren is hanging back. I think I'm going to blink away. Okay, here's a better position for what I want to do. But I'm engulfed. Don't think that's worthwhile. Now I've pulled this vault as well. Well, I can break line of fire with flame now. A line of sight on the siren. No longer mesmerized. And I can heal. Max my MR. Try blinking again. Good. The only expenditure there was some flame. One flame. If I recall correctly. And a couple of lesser humans, maybe. Very minimal. I was able to reduce her pack by 2. And I can hope that they'll disperse, but I doubt they will. In any case, I can deal with the vault nearby separately. Not sure how to fortunately, part of my MR is my weapon, so if I want to hurt the siren, well, I could have thrown tomahawks, that's what I should have done. Whoa. Shard of ice. Time to go. Okay, now that the siren is gone, be in a better position to handle Ilsiuw. This guy's the champ. It's tempting to have. Yeah, I'm gonna have Reflection. And just stare dancer. If she's around. Which she's not. There's that blink. And she summoned allies. Okay, she's poisoned. Oops. Needed to wait for her to step forward. We can do a lesser healing. There she is. Gotta love the lightning. He's got AC. I think I'll just keep going with the lightning. Should reapply poison. I need her to... Oh, there she goes. Trident of Freezing, plus 5. That is better than the Venom Spear. So, I'll take it. With these uniques that have packs, oftentimes it's just a matter of patience and attrition. That's exactly what worked out there. I didn't play every little step perfectly, but I could always have teleported or blinked or whatever, so wasn't a big deal. Okay, vampiric. Want the burst damage with vampiric. Stay with the lack. Vampiric makes for great follower weapons. Some beefy armor for a merfolk. Good follower armor. We got 20% despite all the MR and a fastidious. So I'll put on reflection and charge. Javelin of penetration. I wonder if that ignores reflection. Bit of a rough fight. The merfolk isn't a problem. Can safely change armor. Vestibulus is a great gift for orcs with shields. Drop the digging. Fan would have been handy earlier. polearm is respectable now, so could probably go up to up two levels. You can just walk away from the nymph. Although everything's going to be reaching over her. So. Maybe I'll just rage on this pack. Clearly I'm mopping up now. The main resistance has been crushed. In fact, I think that's it. Wow, a lot of loot. 12 javelins of penetration. Could be nice in Spider. Certainly doesn't lack numbers. No identification scrolls, though. So is there anything I need here for Spire? I guess not, except maybe the javelins of penetration would be fun to have. Which I have room to carry now. I would need to drop something. I should probably just loot the branch. So that I don't forget about stuff I need to identify. Yeah. But this took so long, I'm ready to stop there. So. Overall, there was never any significant danger. And this was all done with minimal expenditure. I danced around with Ilsiuw a bit, but I was just conserving piety and resources. I could have teleported out, I could have greater healing, I could have used heal other on the siren. Plenty of options. Just doing it on a budget. Basically with blink and reflection and flight and very high AC and so forth. This branch wasn't really a significant challenge. Just tedious. So next time I'll take on the Spider 4 in vault after looting. Thanks for watching.